stone circle museum in South Africa has been sharing with us how this is a fossilised bone, and it sings and rings like this beautiful bell, creating a resonance and a beautiful signature frequency. And we're going to do a bit of recording. Stop, give your arms a break. What I'll do is I'll condense those down to create a rhythm that then I can go out into the circles and sing with the sound and the resonance. I just want to sing with it. You can hear the tone. He's like in the trance.
The bone is singing.
Straight to the studios in Australia.
Yeah.
Yeah. Rock guitar.
Your rock guitar.
Rock bone.
That bone, like what you were saying, has congealed blood.
Yes.
So it has the memory of our ancestors. Mm-hmm. So when it rings, we hear its signature frequency ringing. So we hear its song. We hear its song in creation, which helps us remember who we are, where we come from.
This is a new phenomena to me. I'm just wondering why I was not doing this all the time before you came here.
Edwin looks like he's doing a guitar solo. Playing the rock really gently, and Edwin just goes, yeah!
No, I think I have to make it. Yes.
Make it sing.
Yes, make it sing, make it vibrate, and make all the other rocks here vibrate.
Vibrate with it.
Absolutely, yeah. Definitely. Now I'm excited. This is my first time having this lady now coming to tell me that you can form a band just with these fossils and with congealed blood. We know that there is a lot of iron in the rock, and the iron comes from the ground. But if it's congealed blood, then we think that it has to be a fossil, and that iron is from the blood that has been what left inside the whole structure, petrified or transmuted into a whole composite structure, and still it vibrates forever.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you very much. Yes.
Yeah. Thank you, Edwin. That's so cool.